Quantum mechanics has radically changed our worldview. By now, all theoretical physics theories are divided into two groups, classical and quantum. Quantum mechanics forms the basis for all modern theories of elementary particles and their interactions. Some examples are quantum electrodynamics, which describes electromagnetic interactions of charged particles and photons. Quantum chromodynamics, which studies the interaction between quarks and gluons, the building blocks of protons, neutrons, and a lot of other particles. Promising theories like string theory are also based on quantum mechanics. A lot of other models and theories are based on quantum mechanics. Actually, there is no alternative for quantum mechanics. Its predictions confirmed with unprecedented accuracy. Not a single observation has ever been made which would contradict the quantum theory. But what made scientists look for a new theory at the beginning of the 20th century? Almost all observed phenomena could be explained with Newtonian mechanics and Maxwell classical electrodynamics. But unlike today, there were a few contradictions between the predictions of classical theories and actual observations. The atomic stability problem is an example of such a contradiction. From the Rutherford experiments, by the beginning of the 20th century, scientists knew that atoms consist of positively charged particles, protons, and negatively charged particles, electrons. The most popular was the planetary model, in which the electrons go around the massive nucleus, just like the planets go around the Sun. But the calculations showed that such a system would not be stable. According to Maxwell's equations of classical electrodynamics, a charged particle moving in a circle should emit electromagnetic waves. But waves carry energy, and according to the energy conservation law, it should be taken from the electrokinetic energy. So the electron should gradually lose its velocity and finally fall down on the nucleus. According to the calculations, that would happen within a tiny split of a second. If that was true, the world as we know it would not even exist. By heating up a material and letting the light go through the prism, one can see the so-called emission spectrum. This kind of experiments were popular in the 19th century and showed that atoms can emit and absorb electromagnetic waves only of particular frequencies. For example, an atom can emit a photon of frequency ν1 or ν2, but it cannot emit something in between, like greater than ν1 and less than ν2. The emission spectrum of each atom is unique, just like our fingerprints. This is how we know the chemical composition of distant stars. The light carries all the information. It was found useful to draw the so-called energy level diagram of an atom. The frequencies of emitted and absorbed photons can be found as energy differences of any two levels. However, the origin of these discrete energy levels remained a mystery. The existing theories could not give numerical values for those quantized energy levels, as they are called today. Another discrepancy between the theory and observations is known as a ultraviolet catastrophe. The vibration of atoms in the crystal lattice causes the emission of electromagnetic waves called thermal radiation. At room temperature, this radiation is emitted in the infrared range, which is invisible to the human eye, but can be seen with night vision devices. Let's plot the dependence of radiation intensity on its frequency. We obtained a function with a definite maximum. The precise form of the function depends on the chosen temperature. If a metal plate is heated to high temperatures, then the radiation will be mostly in the visible red range. Red hot. So increasing the temperature will shift the maximum to higher frequencies. By further heating, it will move to the ultraviolet region of the spectrum. However, the classical physics predicts that the intensity should keep up increasing with frequency forever. Such a prediction contradicts everyday observations. It shows the fail of classical physics, which is reflected in the name of the paradox, the ultraviolet catastrophe. Historically, the birth of quantum mechanics is associated with solving this problem. It was Max Planck who succeeded in deriving the formula correctly describing thermal radiation. He assumed that energy is emitted only by discrete portions, quanta. The quantum of the electromagnetic field was called a photon. The energy of a photon is proportional to its frequency. The Planck constant serves as the coefficient of proportionality. Now it belongs to the list of fundamental physical constants, just like the speed of light.